Many of you have already seen this RFID reader. It's the RC522. You can read the data of those RFID cards or RFID chips. But we don't want to use this time. We use this little fella, the RDM6300. It comes with an external antenna. This RFID chip works on a 125 kHz base. So we cannot use the same RFID tags we use with this reader. To complete it, we only need an Arduino Nano, jumper cable and a breadboard. The funny part about it, the standard breadboard has quite enough pins to fit the Arduino Nano and the RFID chip. Exactly. The RFID reader hasn't got any markers on it, so we don't know which pin is for what purpose. But hey, that's what we have the internet for. Let's see what we got. We got here some pin headers. Those. Here's your antenna. And here's another 3-pin row. The RFID board has an RX and TX pin. That means it can communicate to other devices via serial interface. You can connect the RX and TX pins to the RX and TX pins on the Arduino. But if we do so, we cannot read our data from the serial monitor when you connect the Arduino to the PC. So we use a serial software library and pin 2 and 3 to connect the reader. First of all, we make the connections to power this little fella up. On this rail, pin 5 is VCC and pin 4 is ground. VCC and ground. And we have a second VCC and ground. Not sure if this is necessary. The pin mark to the outer right is an LED pin. Not sure if this is a status LED and this rail only is for powering the LED, but we connect it anyway. Pin 2 is VCC. And pin 3, the one to the left, is ground. We're looking for the 5-volt out. Yes, guys, this one works with 5-volt. And a ground pin for the common ground. Yeah. This RFID reader is a reader-writer. If we want to write data, we can connect the RX, the receive pin, and the transmit pin to the Arduino. We only want to read data, but we can connect both anyway, just for the fun of it. So pin 1 is TX. It's a pin to the outer right. That comes to D2. And the receive pin, RX, to D3. The RFID reader is equipped with an external antenna. And here's a plug for the antenna. I'm not sure if it matters which one goes in which, but since it's only a coil, I don't think so. So we are finished. Quite an easy setup, isn't it? Let's check out the code. And to be honest, if I hadn't used so many comments, it would fit on one screen. First of all, we include the software serial library. As mentioned, it's necessary because we want an output on the PC screen. The RFID is connected to pin 2 and 3. This we set in the software serial library. We start our serial monitor and the software serial monitor. The loop is as easy as it gets. If the software serial library detects any data, it starts reading the data and it stops as long as there's available data. It reads every single byte and prints it out to our computer. A little space here for better reading. And if there isn't any data left, we get a line break just for style reasons. So we won't have any card data printed in one line. That's it. Let's start it up. We started our serial monitor and let's try out some cards. Here comes card 1. Second card. And a third. Yeah, I guess it works fine. This is one of the easiest projects. It doesn't do anything but reading the cards. But with a little creative mind, you can much do out of it.